Hi, it's Sherry with an update. This is day 5 of my pre-op diet, and I did pretty well today at school. I actually made it with only one Jell-O, and I'm going to be known as the Jell-O hater. I hate Jell-O. But I did discover something about Jell-O today. I like it better at room temperature. Is that gross or what? I like it better. I mean, I was able to, I don't know, eat it without being like, bleh. But anyway, I got home and fixed my little roasted chicken lean cuisine, and the smell kind of made me ickish. And then I took a bite, and I just couldn't do it. I trashed it. I couldn't do it. It's a burnout thing. It's not that they're that gross. They're really pretty decent tasting. I mean, the first one I ate, I was like, yeah, I could do this. But that one tonight, just I couldn't do it again. And I don't, you know, this pre-op diet, you don't have to eat the same meal every night. But the thing is, I've been to 3 stores, and at all 3 stores, it was the only one I could find that fit within their guidelines. So, I got 5 of those, or no, 7 of those. And this was the 5th one, and I couldn't do it. So, what did I do? I just went and got another handy-dandy protein shake and drank it. It would have been so easy to bust out a can of Denny Moore beef stew and eat it. I mean, I was so hungry, but I didn't. I was really good. Drank another protein shake, another 10 or 12 ounces of water. I've had over 80 ounces of water yesterday and 80 ounces of water today. I'm really, really pushing the water. And I don't dislike water. I've always liked water. Some people can't do it, but I like it. So water's not a big thing for me. I also had the caffeine withdrawal over the weekend, and I found today that my caffeine withdrawal headache, I still had a tidbit left. It's gone now. So I believe I've kicked the caffeine again, and I see no reason to pick caffeine back up after the lap band because, you know, it's not good for you anyway. And I was really addicted to caffeine. You know, I had to have my coffee and my unsweet tea. And now I don't even have to have those. So I like tea, though. I'll probably get decaf unsweet tea. I can do that. But anyway, so day 5 is under my belt. You know, I'll probably eat a Jell-O, or a, not a Jell-O, a sugar-free popsicle before I go to bed. And that'll be that. I did get a phone call today. In the middle of switching classes, my cell phone rang at school. And my cell phone hardly ever rings at school. So I wish there had been a hidden camera somewhere to get my reaction when I looked down at the screen and saw who was calling. Because I know I made an idiot of myself. You know, just like stomping and, oh gosh, I gotta take this call. And I ran and talked to the lady on the phone, and she let me know that the insurance has approved me for surgery, and that they will be calling me tomorrow to schedule my surgery. So I will make an update tomorrow to let you know when my surgery date actually is and how day 6 of my diet goes. But after that, I think I am going to switch over to doing weekly videos instead of daily. Unless something big happens or something major that I feel like I need to share. But, you know, this diet is hard. There's nothing easy about it. I'm doing it, and I'm going to make it work, but I'm doing it. And I'll let you know the surgery date. My students, when they saw me acting a fool over the phone call, they were all like, what's that all about? What's going on? So I did tell them, and this is what I shared with them, that the insurance company is going to pay for my surgery. The kids have known for some time now that I was planning on having surgery this school year. And I told them at the beginning of the year that I had some hernias that needed to be repaired, and I went into the whole thing about what a hernia is. And that's the truth. I do have some hernias that need to be repaired. I didn't tell the kids about the lap band. And it's not that I'm keeping it a secret, because all my colleagues know, my whole family knows, and they don't all approve, but they all know. All my friends know, and I'm not keeping it a secret. But the students, you know, I have preteens, you know, I have girls in my class who are becoming very self-conscious about their bodies at this age. And I don't want them to get the idea that it's all about being skinny. And I'm afraid that that's the idea some of them will get. And, you know, when you have a young girl who doesn't have an ounce of fat on her body, I mean, you couldn't pinch an inch anywhere, not even her ears, complaining that she's fat. You know, the last thing you want to do is let that child know you're having weight loss surgery. So I haven't told my students. Some of them may find out. It may trickle on down to them through the grapevine because I'm sure some of the parents are starting to hear from some of the colleagues. You know how it is. And when that time comes, I'll let them know what it's all about, and I'll make sure to stress that I'm doing it for health reasons. And, you know, we already have talked about health and good diet and good exercise and the things that all kids their age need to be doing. I don't see any obesity problems in my classes, and I'm really glad of that, you know. And I live in Kentucky, and it is a big deal in Kentucky. You know, obesity is running rampant in Kentucky and Tennessee. And I don't see a lot of that in the kids in my classes. So that's a good sign that, you know, people are starting to get out and move more. Kids are getting out and moving more. But anyway, going off on another whole tangent. I'll update tomorrow with my surgery date. After that, I'm switching to weekly videos. I'll probably have my husband take this camera to document the day of my surgery and hope that he doesn't get anything too ugly on there. Like me coming from under anesthesia and saying ugly things. So, have a good evening. Talk to you tomorrow.